You are listening to The Sauce Podcast, recorded live deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York, in the FingerLakes1.com Stew Studios, featuring Dandy, Aaron D, Saucy, Yo, Media Stew, Tony Sometimes, and now,
happy birthday! It is February 20th, 2012. This is episode number 40 of the Sauce Podcast. What a show tonight.
Happy birthday, Tony.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. Dandy.
Happy birthday, buddy.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Snowcones.
What? A lady voice.
Tonight, up here in the, how would you describe these studios? FingerLakes1.com studios.
Quaint.
Versatile?
Certainly. Certainly versatile.
Up here tonight in the versatile studios of FingerLakes1.com, I'm joined with a few people that went to my birthday party the other night. And some that didn't.
What a party.
True.
Media Stew.
Tony Sometimes for mayor of Seneca Falls.
Saucy Joe.
Shit show.
And Dandy Aaron RSVP D.
He's a man. He's 40.
And a very special guest tonight. She's originally hails from Seneca Falls. Some of you Finger Lakes One listeners may know her as Snowcones, author of the popular Finger Lakes One blog in days of yore, Snowcones. She's also lived in Alaska. She currently lives in Houston. She's married to a geologist, and she writes a Dining for Two blog of our popular blog in Houston, where her and her geologist husband head out to local restaurants and then say what they think about it. She also
is adept at
using social media for businesses, and she's does a type of digital marketing services down in Houston.
Holy wow.
Yeah. And I'm humbled. I'm
what
tired.
A resume.
Snowcones, welcome.
Thank you. It's great to be here, guys.
Welcome, Cone Baby.
Thank you.
That creepy fucking voice of yours.
Is creepy Stew's back.
You're going to get a lot of that tonight.
Oh, boy.
Fuck yeah.
I guess.
It seriously sends a shiver down my spine every time you do it.
You love it.
No.
Well, we have a lot of stuff to talk about. We're going to catch up with Snowcones, a.k.a. Christina. And we're going to do a little Stew's news.
There's some listener mail.
There's some listener mail tonight.
Or it's listener / viewer mail.
But first, let's try to figure out why it was that all my podcasting friends would join me at my 40th birthday party, yet somebody wouldn't show up who RSVP'd they would. I'm
what
talking about you, Dandy. What Randy.
A party.
Explain yourself.
I got sick. What do you want, man?
What kind of sick?
I woke up Saturday and thought I was getting the flu that was going around, so I wanted to be proactive, and I killed it.
How'd you kill it?
DayQuil and NyQuil all day.
That's the thing. Is those they don't cure things. They just
oh, I cure.
It's
it.
Just another excuse
you
for
well
you
rested.
To get fucked up.
You do. So what? Do you think I just skipped your birthday party? I even fucking shaved, for God's sakes.
Hey, well, you didn't need to shave for this party.
No. From what I hear, I'm
oh,
kind of
no,
glad I stayed
didn't.
Home. But
whoa.
I did bring you a present. Just because I feel bad, so you
sweet.
Talk and I'll go get it. All
right. I mean, I'll put. We have some music for this.
Oh, you got a special present?
Two.
Is this the fishing hole music? Oh, no. Sweet happy birthday.
It's birthday jam.
AJ was coming on the phone.
I did speak to him earlier today.
That's nasty.
He's doing well.
Did he wish you a happy birthday?
That was the purpose of his call.
Oh, look at that.
What is this?
Oh, my.
Boy, I could really use this. And
are
some,
you kidding?
And some protective underwear.
Oh. Wow. He got you a walker and adult diapers for your 40th birthday.
That's sweet
I
of him.
I could have used these on Saturday night.
Yeah,
you could have.
But your mouth.
Well, a walker, just what everybody wants for their birthday.
That'll come in handy.
I guess it's all right.
Sooner than later.
My party dandy with these great gifts.
I put a lot of thought into those.
You just got zinged.
Oh, yeah, you did. Zing.
Wow.
Zingbot.
Let me show our webcast visitors my awesome present. It's a walker. It's a elderly person's walker.
Yeah, not the Texas
it's a
Ranger
slightly,
variety.
The slightly used walker.
Well, I mean, even Texas Ranger will use that.
And some disposable protective underwear, maximum absorbency, formerly super plus absorbency.
16 pair.
Let me say this about that kind of thing. Why include the word disposable? Would you want, would they be anything else other than disposable? No.
I'm going to wash them.
It was
them,
funny
son.
When I walked up to the counter and asked the lady if she sold single pairs of adult diapers.
Oh, yeah.
You just wanted one?
Just one.
I
only
need one.
To use them.
It's for a joke. You don't know that.
I think Tony's thinking about putting one on. Right
go out in the hallway and put a pair on.
I'm not going to put a pair of these on.
Just let her rip. Just piss your pants.
Yeah.
Somebody should do it.
If we ever have a podcast-a-thon, we'll need those because we won't be able to leave.
That's just put them.
I'll save them for a special occasion.
This studio's got everything, I'm telling you.
Yeah,
adult diapers.
Talk about being versatile.
They can. You can also use them too, so you don't shit your pants again.
Again,
that's true. That's true. I have shit my pants. But what he didn't tell us about that story when he said it.
Let's not talk about it.
That was recent.
Let's
like
not talk,
weeks ago.
Let's not talk about
you
it. Anymore.
Scumbag.
I don't want to talk about it.
You just ratted out Stu.
I did.
You low down dandy.
You're rotten, dude. You shit your pants. No.
Yes, yeah.
No. Never like you.
He doesn't like you.
Not to the level that you have.
Something else.
Well, if you're going to do something, you got to commit. Oh, you went right at it.
RSVP.
Now, on Saturday night, I indulged.
Yes, you did.
And at the end of the night, I got home and realized I didn't have my cell phone, which is a heartbreaking thing, but I just immediately passed out. Then I woke up the next morning and I realized I didn't have my cell phone. You know, it was like, oh,
heartbreak was bad.
Yeah, harder than ever because now I wasn't had the capacity to comprehend everything that meant. So listen to what I did. I went down into the computer in my basement, got on the internet, and searched for lost my cell phone, lost my Droid. And some apps came up. Accessed that search listing and went to the Google Android Marketplace and found an app that I could install remotely on my phone, assuming it was still on. If it was off, I would have been screwed. So I installed it on my phone remotely. Then I had to send a text from my wife's phone to my phone to, like, kick it into active registration or something. And then I go back down on the computer, pull up a map, arrow right where my phone is.
No shit.
At one of my buddy's houses. He had seen it and brought it home because he knew that I was had left. And so I no longer was concerned. He slept a little later than me, so I just waited a while and then went and got my phone. Isn't that kind of amazing? I mean, just thinking that you could do something like that even 5-6 years ago.
And with a hangover to boot because you had to feel like shit.
He claims no.
I don't get hungover the way normal mortals do.
You don't drink like normal people either.
That's it. You don't drink like
normal
people.
I don't.
Media student sound healthy yesterday morning when I called him.
That's why I do not drink often. Because when I do, I drink Dos Equis, like 60 of them. No, actually, I drink Crown Royal.
And Jameson.
Yeah, that was the only thing that screwed up the perfect formula is I mixed a few Jameson shots in there. But honestly, I didn't feel great Saturday morning, but I wasn't sick as you would have suspected I would because I keep it clean, you know?
You did not keep it clean on your birthday.
I heard you got smacked in the face by a female.
Wait, you got kicked in the nuts.
Yeah, and that has nothing to do with me like being mean to anybody. This girl was straight up crazy.
So where do you want to start this discussion of this night? I mean, did we start when I first made contact with you? A half an hour into the party, and you were already well on your way. Sails were fucking set.
Yeah, I was on a mission that night.
Mission accomplished, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. It was fun. I had a lot of laughs.
You initiated your campaign for mayor.
Yep. And a lot of people didn't know. Unfortunately, Santa Claus doesn't have a mayor anymore. No. So, because we have a town supervisor. But
purely ceremonial.
That's actually why that girl kicked me in the nuts. Said, I got out of the car, and I said, I'm the mayor of this town, or something like that.
Proclaimed himself.
And she, like, took 6 or 7 steps running towards me, hauled off and kicked me in the nuts. And luckily for me, it wasn't a clean shot. She caught, like, the inside of my leg first, and it...
glancing blow?
It hurt a little bit, but not. It wasn't. I might have had to go to the hospital if it was a clean
blow. Do you know who this
person
is?
No, I don't, but other people seem... A couple other people said they think they know who she is.
Who? So, let's fucking say her name.
I don't remember who... I don't
See,
remember.
But the story doesn't end there, Dandy.
It's not over yet.
This girl makes a return appearance.
She loops back around.
Her boyfriend was with her and some other people, I guess, and they, after that, there's a whole hubbub, like, people holding her back.
Hubbub.
Like, she really wanted to kill me for some reason. Off they go down to the Bulls Run. About, I had no sense of time,
refuel.
But... Later, you know, later on, I'm outside in front of Red's, and that same posse starts coming up from Bulls Run, and when they were about, 20, 30 yards away maybe, I said, hey, that's that bitch that kicked me in the nuts right there. She heard me, took off, running right at me, 100 miles an hour, as fast as she could, roundhouse punch to the back of the head.
I would have clotheslined that bitch.
I don't even really remember that part of it so much. I do remember once it was retold to me, but it didn't seem to hurt. What happened?
We lost power.
To what?
No, I think looks like we're recording over there.
Pretty low.
Oh, it's out.
What's out?
I can't hear nothing.
Yeah, the phones are out. The microphones.
They're fine.
There we go.
There they are.
We're back.
It's all fine. Carry on.
That was strange.
There's a loose connection.
Yeah, there's a loose connection for
it's
sure.
Just the phones.
But anyways, long story short, yeah. But the second time, like, then there even more people were, like, pulling her off. I have this vision of her, like, kicking her feet and, you know, while somebody else is holding her up in the air, she's trying to wiggle loose so she can come and punch me again.
I wonder what you're saying.
Nothing. I told you what I said. I didn't say anything, and that's been confirmed.
Right now.
I know.
That's been confirmed. So
you were on fire, though. You were saying, Ethan, you were saying some awesome stuff.
I was going to rape someone or something like that? I said a lot of that? A lot
of rape talk.
The thing about that is everybody knows that I'm not a rapist and that I will never rape. And the only way I could have gotten in trouble is if there's an actual rape victim there, but I'm pretty sure there wasn't.
Yeah. I mean, you didn't really... You were raping everybody.
Nobody was afraid.
If you actually raped even half the people you said you were going to rape, you would be one of the all-time...
Most prolific rapers.
Yeah, prolific rapers of all time. For real.
So that's why that doesn't seem to bother me. It doesn't bother me. I mean, I realize that that's very crude, but, you know, got a few laughs.
Oh, you got some laughs.
And, it was a good time.
You were punching. You were doing a lot of punching.
No.
Yeah, you punched me like 3 times.
Yeah, but not hard, right?
No, but you would just really like, you'd punch me and then yell out, StuFromTheSaucePod.com!
Yeah.
That's just karma from when you used to do it to me, you prick.
I'm going
to
do it. Next time I fucking see you out, I'm punching you right in the mouth.
You don't go out anymore.
Don't punch. I quit drinking. Nobody punch.
I'll make a fucking special trip.
So, anyway, it was a good party.
Yeah, it was fun.
The cake was great.
I didn't have a cake, any of the cake.
You will.
I do
There's
have
leftovers.
Some in the fridge, yeah.
Make sure you get in there because it's delicious.
Went by so fast.
Well, it would.
Your whole campaign took place over the cake, and you didn't get any.
You really...
Now, let me tell you guys this.
You really
I
sent it home with the old...
Yeah.
After the speech?
How do you describe it?
It's, what do you call that move?
It's a pro wrestler does it.
It is a groin chop. Yeah. After your speech was over, you
double groin
gave
chop.
The whole room one of those.
See, the thing about that is I don't really remember too much about that. You would have thought that the speech went horribly wrong, but what I've been told, it was a wonderful speech.
It was a great speech.
It was a great speech.
Considering the seconds before that, when the candles are lit and we were outside and you were on the rape rant, and then you went... Seamlessly from that to a
like a family speech.
You got to know the situation.
Yeah.
Followed up with a groin chop.
Know your audience.
I didn't want people to think that I was too nice of a guy.
No, that's a groin chop audience.
Yeah. No doubt. I think it was appreciated.
It was.
Agreed.
I appreciated it.
I know I'm definitely groin chopping this Christmas.
Oh, when you cut the Christmas ham.
It's your ham.
Ooh. Hey, speaking of ham.
Okay.
Let's talk about ham.
Yesterday, Sunday, I did something that I'm going to recommend that everybody does. This is going to be a pre-recommendation. Every now and then, man, you got to roast a turkey. Full bird. I'm serious. Throw it in the oven. It takes two. Well, you let it thaw. Then you take out the gizzards and the neck. You know, and I usually just throw them away. Although you could make a soup. And then a little olive oil, salt and pepper, and Italian spices. And rub it all over the bird. Throw a few lemons inside. Slice up some lemons. Throw it in the body cavity. Roast it. And when it's done, you got so much awesome turkey. I like to call it day after Thanksgiving in February.
That's a great name for it. Mm-hmm. Question, technique. How do you go about tenderizing the bird?
I didn't even tenderize it. I was not.
Are you sure you didn't tenderize it?
Oh, well, yeah. The night before when I came home from the party, after my wife, I was dropped off. Snowcones had spent the night. They were having a little slumber party.
Really?
Down watching some TV in the living room.
After they left you at the bar.
Yeah. Well, he wouldn't leave. He refused to leave.
I know. We had to drag him to the car, and he was still mad.
We had to relieve.
I'm staying out all night. It's my 40th birthday.
I'm a man.
I'm 40.
But apparently the turkey was out in my car. I didn't drive home. I got dropped off, but I went out to the car. I must have stopped in the car and got the turkey out of the car because I knew it was in there. And then I walked into the living room and I hurled it.
All right. Well, I heard that you threw turkey at your wife, but not a whole turkey.
Mm-hmm. I did not throw it at my wife. I don't want that rumor started. I threw it in a neutral position in the middle of the floor.
You threw it across the floor.
Because honestly, if you're sitting on the couch watching TV and you see like a frozen turkey just flying in the middle of the room, and you're like, what?
Yeah.
I was like,
the shock
what?
Value. Yeah.
In February.
And in February, no less. If it was November, I would maybe have not been so shocked.
Now, this is a motherfucking slumber party.
It's a camp over.
But the point being, I sliced it up. Now I got turkey sandwiches, you know, all week long.
All week.
The dog has turkey. Special treat
meat.
For the dog.
Special treat.
I got so much turkey, he can have the white meat. And my daughter likes turkey, too. My wife's also getting concerned about, you know, us running out of turkey because I put a bunch in to give to somebody. And she's like, and I'm like, trust me, by the time this turkey's going to go bad before we eat it all. But anyways, you know, I don't even remember what I paid for the turkey, maybe $20. But you roast that shit. The room smells nice. That night I had a little mashed potatoes and stuffing, too, with the family, a little. That was Thanksgiving in February. Right. Today is day after Thanksgiving in February. I observed by me.
And it's your birthday.
And it's
my birthday, yeah.
And it's President's Day.
Now, what would you guys do if you could have a freaking fresh roasted turkey on Wonder Bread with some mayonnaise or Miracle Whip, whatever your preference is, maybe even mustard, salt and pepper. Oh, man. Hits the spot, right?
Why'd you bring some?
No, why'd I bring some to you? You don't even go to my fucking birthday party. You bring me a walker. You think I'm going to give you a turkey sandwich?
I'm just looking out for you.
I got a real turkey.
Well, as a matter of fact.
He's opening up a drawer. There's a drawer being opened, and out
is. I brought turkey sandwiches for everyone.
Wow.
Thank you, sir.
Got some Wonder Bread. I got some Hellmann's, but I don't have a knife. You're going to have to spread it with your finger. I got some Miracle Whip. That's squeezable. No need for a knife. And I got some French's yellow mustard.
Yes.
It's like a turkey dinner in here.
And I have the, what else do we have in here? A little salt. And a little black pepper.
Wow.
And turkey.
It's a feast.
It's like a picnic.
I feel like Tiny Tim right now.
I had paper
God bless
towels
us, everyone.
Too.
sounded just like him.
Is anybody going to have one of these since I went through the trouble or no?
Turkey I'll pie. Have a half a turkey sandwich. Can I have a half?
Screw you. You're dead to me.
Oh.
Go big or go home. If I taught you anything
big.
Saturday night, it's go big or go home.
In that case, you better have 30 half turkey sandwiches.
Go big.
I'll make my turkey sandwich first.
You did drink the place out of
Crown. It's my birthday.
You did drink them out of Crown.
Yeah, but luckily, Partygoer had given me Crown.
People who know you
and
well.
So we restocked. Hold on one second. I got to grab some paper towels. You guys take it from here for a few seconds.
Okay.
Can you believe that he brought us turkey sandwiches?
Not really.
What a guy.
I enjoy turkey.
Your wife didn't want us to have your turkey?
She thought they were going to run out.
We're going to run out of turkey.
Our supply is
Tony,
low.
Sometimes our turkey supply is running dangerously low.
Yeah, my wife, the vegetarian, was afraid we're going to run out of turkey. She doesn't even eat turkey. Although a lot of people, my wife will say, I'm a vegetarian. And they'll say, oh, you eat chicken, though, and you know, white meat, right?
No,
that's
meat.
That's meat. No, vegetarian. So. Actually, you guys talked about eating before you came down here. I haven't really eaten nothing. Actually, I had a turkey sandwich.
Get in there.
I'm going to have another one.
Nothing wrong with multiple turkey sandwiches.
It is real easy to roast a turkey, though.
I hope you don't fall asleep on us. Let's do some stews news while you make sandwiches.
I'm only making one. You bitches make your own, but I'll pass around the fixins.
Hit it.
Baby, you got a stew going.
Nomophobia, fear of being without your phone, is on the rise.
Holy, I experienced that.
Huh? You like that? Topical. Do you feel anxious if your cell phone isn't nearby? Does just the thought of losing your phone make your heart pound? How about you, Tony, to make your heart pound?
Yeah, which was actually good. I was glad my heart was still pounding on Sunday morning.
Do you keep an extra phone on hand just in case your primary phone breaks?
No.
I actually do.
I have one.
I got a backup.
If you have a warranty on your phone, don't turn your other one on, though. As soon as you turn the one phone on, you lose the warranty. I found that out a couple of months ago.
There's a helpful tip.
Bitches.
Tip from Dandy R&D.
And that's a dandy tip.
I wish I had the music queued up like Jesus.
Oh, that was a dandy moment right there.
It sure was.
Do you sometimes take your phone to bed with you?
All the times.
Every night.
I use it as my alarm.
Me
my
too.
Alarm
clock.
I can answer no to all of these questions.
All of these questions.
Do you bring your home phone with you to bed at night?
Yes. Now this is what I do. I put the mayonnaise on the bread, and then I pepper the bread.
Would you like some turkey with your mayonnaise?
And then I salt the
For
bread.
Real?
That's Miracle Whip. It's a sandwich
that's
bread.
Because if that thing is up.
I don't eat either of those things.
So since we all answered yes to any of those questions,
no,
we are all nomophobes.
No.
And you're not alone. Nomophobia, the fear of being without your cell phone, is on the rise, according to a new report sponsored by Secure Envoy, a company that specializes in digital passwords.
That's perfect. Who better to do the survey than those people?
Yeah, right.
Using the online polling service OnePoll, Secure Envoy found that 66% of 10,000 people surveyed in the United Kingdom say they fear losing or being without their phone.
6,600 people.
Dang!
4 years ago, in a similar survey, only 53% were suffering from
two-thirds
the nomophobia affliction.
Nomophobes?
You're a nomophobe.
I like it when my phone doesn't work, though. It doesn't bother me.
Nomophobes.
If I go somewhere and...
You lose signal?
If I lose it, or even if my data plan doesn't work in a particular geographical area.
Oh, boy. I'm not a nomophobe.
Dandy, you going to have a sandwich?
I'm a nomophone.
Yes, sir.
Dandy, you going to have a sandy?
Nomophone for me.
Here you go.
That's what I say.
Here's the paper towel.
Swedish man survives for months in snowed-in car.
2 months.
That's right.
What?
Let's
Swedish
drive
man
the news bus and you just sit back.
Was dug out alive after being snowed in his car on a forest track for 2 months with no food, police and local media report on Saturday. The 45-year-old man from southern Sweden was found on Friday, emaciated and too weak to utter more than a few words. He was found not far from the city of Umeå in the north of Sweden by snowmobilers who thought they had come across a car wreck until they dug their way to a window and saw movement inside. The man who was lying in the back seat in a sleeping bag said he had been in the car since December 19th.
Oh, that's before Christmas.
That's important. I bet you he wishes he had a phone.
How did he survive?
The man is recovering from being rescued by police and a rescue team. Statement said he was doing well considering the circumstances. Doctors at the hospital said humans would normally be able to survive about 4 weeks without food. Hmm. Besides eating snow, the man probably survived by going into a dormant-like state, physician Stephen Branth told.
Like a bear. It's called hibernating.
Yep. A bit like a bear that hibernates, humans can do that as well.
Oh, I should try that.
He probably had a body temperature of around 31 degrees Celsius, which is, I don't know what that
is. Not enough to live. Shouldn't be, but I guess it is.
Due to the low temperatures, not much energy was used, so. Yeah, fucking crazy, right? Can you imagine?
That's really crazy.
No.
How do you get snowed into that extent, though? Like,
step one, live in Sweden.
Yeah, it's true.
How soon do you think he ran out of cigarettes?
Probably pretty soon.
I don't think he could have smoked them in that state, in that car, covered completely, no ventilation.
Clam baking that bitch.
Bet you he wishes he was having a clam bake. Probably starving. Thinking about clams. Just baking in general.
How's that turkey? What did you put on yours, Christina? French's? Mustard? I know you're not a fan of mayonnaise or any egg-based spread.
You are correct on all counts.
Secret $1 million gold stash discovered in French rafters.
Dang!
A French champagne producer is spreading the wealth with his workers after they discovered nearly $1 million in gold coins stashed away in the building's rafters, according to the French press.
Wow.
Bullion.
One of the workers was attacking the building's ceiling with a crowbar when gold coins started to rain down on him, followed by sacks of gold.
Wait, he was attacking? Sacks of gold. He was attacking the rafters?
That's what it says, attacking. I'm assuming they're doing a little demolition.
Okay. And then just sacks of gold rained down?
Yeah.
Bullion.
Let's see. In all, 497 gold coins were unearthed, with the majority literally raining down upon the workers who were busy renovating the building.
Holy shit. You know how awesome that must have been? The fucking gold coins just start raining down from the ceiling, and you're just there doing demolition?
At first you're scared, then you realize what it is.
These are gold coins!
Then you start dancing around in it.
Minted between 1851 and 1928, the coins have a face value marking of $20 each. However, together they are now worth an estimated $980,000.
Fuck, bonanza.
Dang.
Lang says he'll keep half the money for himself while splitting half with the workers who made the discovery.
Wow.
That cheapskate. Split up evenly.
I would have been shoving gold in my pockets.
I'm sure they were.
There probably were more coins and someone ferreted some away. Let me say this. You go have a drink at the bar, you toss one of those as a tip, fucking coolest guy in town forever.
That's right.
Bing, here. Take this, fella.
Or you toss one in the Salvation Army kettle around Christmas, then you make the local news.
And that is Stu's news.
That was good news.
Baby, you got a stew going.
I'm gonna make myself a sandwich.
There's like lobster tails, filet mignon.
How'd you get
that? There's not much better than a turkey sandwich of this nature, in my mind.
Yeah.
All you gotta do it, Stu.
Spreading the Hellmann's with a
Tootsie Roll.
Hey, do what you gotta do.
Wow.
This isn't my first rodeo.
This is ghetto as it gets.
That's really good.
There's something really gross about watching you do that.
That's pretty nasty. I'm actually getting a little grossed out.
So, Christina, tell us about your Houston dining blog.
Okay.
How does it work?
The one that I write with my husband is called To Dine For.
Is that how it's actually pronounced? To Dine For? Like To Die For?
Yes, exactly. It's a play. It's a play on that.
T-W-O or T-O-O?
The two is actually the number.
Which is also a reference to the fact that there's two of you.
Right.
I thought it was to dine for Houston.
Right. No, it's about
like
it's
the,
two.
Like a verb. Like it was like, the action. Of.
You've read it. Jim mocked it thoroughly at his birthday party. So you
did
get
I?
You get a general idea of what it's about.
I think it's a great idea, actually, especially in
a
more metropolitan area like that. There's need for reviews like that. Now, if you were to do it around here, it'd be like, you know, everybody's eaten in any restaurant around here a few times. Mm-hmm. You'd run out of places.
Houston has one of the biggest, it's sort of a dining out city.
That's such nonsense.
No, it really, it's true. People spend, and the turnover is ridiculous. Like a new restaurant will open and close before you even
those
get
are the ones you
got to
review. Now, is it, how often do you publish?
We update once a week, and then there are a few other features that get updated throughout the week. Shorter reviews when we go to media tastings or...
No, they don't get sent out on your mailing list, I take it then. Not everything?
No, no, not all the content, just the weekly
review. Because I'm on the list.
Did you call those short order reviews?
For two?
Is that what you said? Short order reviews?
Shorter reviews.
Oh. See, they should go keep that pun thing going and just make it short order reviews.
To dying for.
All right. I'll talk to my people about it. Well, one of them is called features, you know, with the emphasis on the word eat. In there.
See that? I
know. And another one's around.
They should
the
hire
town.
Me to think of names for things.
All right.
Talk to your people.
I'll talk to my people.
Especially if your people are just
But it's
your
fun.
Husband.
We do it, and we do it once a week, and we get to try a lot of different food. And that is one of the best things about Houston is there's
do
a lot of good food
there. Do you have to pay for
there.
The dinners?
We do pay for our own dinners, but we do get paid to write for the website, too.
It's a win-win.
It is a win-win. It supplements our existing dining budget.
So do you guys stick to, like, low-class, low-cost options?
We do. We run the gamut. You know, anything from food trucks to really expensive.
I want to run a food truck.
Food trucks
They're
are the sweeping best. The nation. Mm-hmm.
There's tons in Houston. They're good.
How would you write a review if it were you about that sandwich you just ate?
it's unfinished. It's unfinished.
Yeah. You know, the thing is, this is a great way to eat a turkey sandwich, but my preference, if I had my druthers, I would have stuffing and gravy over it, and I would have a hot, open face.
Oh, well,
that's
shit.
How I do my leftover turkey sandwiches.
How about a webcam pointing straight at your face while you're eating?
Oh, that sounds amazing. Let's add that.
Yeah, let's
right
do
up.
That.
Oh, yeah. I don't worry about this. It's that black thing right in front of you.
I see I'd it. Like I'm gonna put. Can I put the mustard in front of it?
I'd say like a pig on that. Totally forgot about it.
So
it was a side view. Nom.
That is of interest to people in Houston, yeah?
What?
That blog.
Yes, it is.
But they have other branches, other
yep.
two twos that
two
dine
other cities,
for.
Boston and Nashville.
Typical.
Typical.
Now, I heard that Nashville is a really good city for dining out as well.
I think it is.
And Boston.
Yeah.
Now, do like when you show up at a restaurant, do like the chefs get nervous and
no,
start freaking out?
No, because we do it anonymously. Like, we don't like tell people. I mean,
yeah, by the nature of the fact that no one knows who the hell you are.
But I just mean like we don't tell the waitress, "Hey, we're here to review" or
sure,
anything like that.
Sure, of course
that.
Not. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But it's kind of hard sometimes. They guess when you're taking pictures. But most of the time, it's a big foodie town, and there's lots of food bloggers, so they don't get too freaked out about it.
Yeah. Do you ever see Ratatouille?
Yeah, it's Joshua's favorite.
Me too. Me too. Favorite animated movie.
It's a good one, actually.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, Rambo's his favorite movie, but Ratatouille is definitely
mine too.
That stands to reason.
Twinsies.
Wow. So, you say we had some listener mail?
We do.
That's a fact.
Let's hit it up.
You got some letters.
Master, I have mail for you.
There's a letter in your mailbox.
You got mail, baby.
All right. It just so happens the subject of tonight's email is tonight's special guest. Dear Sauce Pod, I was happy to hear about tonight's special guest. I have a few questions for her.
Oh,
what's
perfect.
Your favorite color and why?
Well, I'm a big fan of yellow because it's cheerful, just like my disposition.
What's your favorite meal?
Turkey sandwiches.
My favorite meal? That's really hard.
Only sometimes just turkey sandwiches.
My favorite homemade meal is my dad's sauce, and my favorite going out meal is the spaghetti with olive oil and garlic at Antonina's.
Wow. For real?
Well, yeah.
That's your favorite?
It. With mushrooms. I love that freaking thing, dude.
In the whole world, that's your most favorite thing?
I got to tell you right now it is because I know I only have a certain number.
Because you can only get it here.
Times I can eat it again.
You know, I've heard that that's just a rumor.
Yeah?
I mean, she's trying. I've heard that she's trying to dispel that they're for sale.
If I can eat that every day, then other dishes have room to move up the list.
I'm just saying I'm not so sure I want the sauce pie to be a part of this rumor mongering if, in fact, it is rumor.
Is it rumor mongering?
I don't know. I've heard that she is that she's saying no. You know, we talked about Red's Place being for sale on this podcast. There's actually real estate listings online for that.
There are.
There's not for Antonina's. So.
Well, then.
And they were around town as they renewed their liquor license. And that's not a license just to lick women.
No,
it's to serve alcohol,
license, yeah.
Which you need for a restaurant.
Right. Pow.
A liquor license, you don't need for to lick a woman. A license to lick a woman is not necessarily for a restaurant. Necessary for a restaurant.
Nope.
It's a play on words like your blog.
Oh, I get it. I get it. I'm just not sure. I'm glad I got it.
What would you drink with your favorite meal?
Oh, okay.
Not done yet.
Now we got to do one of each, because what will you drink with
your
bad
sauce? Well, no,
because
it's the same. They're both. I would drink Chianti with either one of those.
Probably.
And what is your favorite song?
Is it by Weird Al Yankovic?
My favorite song?
Is it Dandy by the Kinks?
That's my favorite song.
Right now... Well, I know who's asking these questions, and I think she would want me to say, is it Bootylicious by Beyonce? Some song like that. But
it's
right
not a
now,
quiz. There's no right or wrong
no,
answer
I think
here.
There is. No, okay. And right now I'm listening to a lot of Uncle Lucius, which is a band from Austin. So anything by them is sort of what I'm listening to.
Uncle Lucius.
They're
thanks,
good.
Anonymous Taco Girl.
Nice. It's good to hear from her from time to time.
There's a follow-up.
P.S.
If I could open it. Does your special guest ever consider just grabbing her dog and the damn geologist and moving home? It would make a lot of people happy.
What she says is, do you ever consider quitting your awfully selfish ways and just moving home? To make everyone else happy? I think that's what she was saying.
That's what it says.
I think she was saying that you're selfish. Was the gist of what I heard.
I don't
support that. I just, that's what I heard.
Is there a second email this week?
No.
That was the second email.
Oh,
it was actually
part
a follow-up email.
Got another Chinese email.
What's that one say?
I don't know. It's in Chinese.
Oh, got to brush up on that. You're Chinese.
Not going to do it.
No plans to move home.
Not rolling up the wagons.
Nope.
Heading back east.
Nope. Be nice.
Life
though.
On the frontier.
There is a.
Be nice though.
The hydrofracking.
So let me ask you this.
That's not the kind of geology he does.
I thought one geologist can do it all. I thought he was the best.
He likes different stuff, so.
Fracking is not his cup of tea, man.
He's more of a driller.
Yeah. Drill, baby, drill.
Right, Christina?
That's what he says.
Oh, yeah.
So what's the best meal you've had in Houston?
Oh, okay.
Now that's the question.
There have been two recently, and one of them is at this place called Samba Grill.
You can't have two best.
Which is downtown. It's hard. And then the other one is this new place called Uchi Houston. And Uchi Austin was this really big deal. High-end, modern, Japanese, like, fancy.
And what would you have?
They do a 10-course chef's tasting menu, so they just bring you whatever the chef decides he wants that day. So we had all kinds of stuff. It was crazy. It was good. A little sashimi, a little sushi, some hot dishes, some, ribs.
Nice.
It was great. And the Samba Grill place is downtown, and that's like a South American steakhouse, and it's badass. And
I'm
I happened to...
doing a Samba. That was a Samba.
Yeah. And I met their chef, and he's really cute. He's a young guy.
It's a little mouse that lives in a guy's hat.
It is a little mouse. You ruined the surprise.
But it's a South American mouse, so he's more like Speedy Gonzalez.
I forgot about Speedy Gonzalez.
Our great allies to the south. Brazil.
Home. of the 2016 Summer Olympic Games.
Beautiful women.
The land of beautiful women.
They leave little to the imagination. With the bikinis and whatnot.
It's true.
He doesn't talk creepy like you, though.
Ah, Brazil.
Let's see, what do I got on my list here? That's it?
Show's over.
Short list.
What about Jeremy Lin? Anyone catch Linsanity?
Oh, yeah. Even I've been paying attention.
It's crazy.
It is crazy.
I love a young upstart.
There's a chink in his armor, though.
Oh, that's, so yesterday. Was it yesterday, Sunday, or
it
Saturday?
It was late in the night that the headline went up, and it only lasted for like 20 minutes. It was on their ESPN's mobile site.
Yeah, and ESPN's mobile site.
The headline read, chink in the armor after the Knicks had lost, and needless to say, the reporter who penned that was fired from ESPN.
Now, Cones, you're a freelance writer. Would you ever?
Never.
Ever.
What I don't understand is,
when you review Asian restaurants,
almost never use that word.
Everything but the kitchen chink.
Of course
not. We don't read it right there.
No, but I don't understand. That has to go through at least one editor, right? I mean, it's not like the guy's posting it like live to himself.
Oh, I think they do. I think at ESPN,
it's got to go through at least one editor.
No, I think that the culture at ESPN is there is less, especially with their, you know, it's all online. It's either on TV or online. But I think that at some level, these guys are just got to get it up there. I don't think that there's so much information. I don't think there's a filter, honestly.
Listen, there's just no way that the writer who wrote that like is the one that went in and posted it live. I refuse to believe that. At a publication like ESPN, even online, no way. It went to an editor, one editor.
I disagree.
Well, the point here is that guy claims that he had no knowledge of the slang.
Yeah, he thought it was just a clever headline.
No way.
Right?
No.
Well, let me say this then. Do you think that two people had no knowledge of that?
It's impossible. I just don't understand.
It makes no sense. I can understand one idiot posting it, whether he knows it or not. I can see that.
Do you really?
But if it does have to go through an editor, there's no way, as a professional editor, you don't know that can't fly.
In my mind, though, why would you even go to the armor reference?
It's an amazing coincidence that you use that phrase but don't know what it means.
Yeah.
No, I think he knows what it means, but he didn't think it was derogatory for whatever reason. He thought that
chink's
was
not derogatory?
I'm saying that's what he thought.
Not in that sense. It's not, if you just say there's a chink in the armor, that's not derogatory.
Yeah.
But
how do you know that's not what he was saying? How do you know?
Given the fact that they
well,
lost.
Well, the article's about Jeremy Lin.
Right.
Yeah, but I mean, he probably didn't even think about it. He was probably just writing it, not even thinking that the kid's fucking Chinese.
Jeremy, well, he's an American, actually, born in Palo Alto, California.
Right.
But I think what they're terming him now is Asian American,
yeah,
because his parents were from the Taiwan, I believe. His mother was from Taiwan. So, but
it would be an amazing coincidence if he just used that phrase.
Maybe
for
right.
that particular
no,
loss.
He used it because he knew that Jeremy Lin is Asian American. He just didn't think it was offensive for whatever reason, because the guy is an idiot, must be. I guess
that is a third option, that he used it and fully aware of the term and what it meant, but not that it was derogatory.
That's what I think.
I agree with that. That's a third option, sure.
Although as unlikely as it may seem.
I don't think I've heard anybody call the chink since I was in like fucking middle school, though. You know,
for good reason.
But he's a grown man. He's probably old. Do you think like old dudes walk around that fucking chink? You know, I don't.
Goddamn Japs.
I just don't think that people use it like that. You know.
Either
way,
do.
Because I'm a pretty fucking disgusting person and like mean guy. I don't say that.
Oh, so you're the
I'm the barometer.
Level. Yeah, you're the barometer for old dandy, social barometer.
Dandy.
Moral dandy.
Dandy wants to have a scavenger hunt.
I think it's a good idea.
Would you Sauce Pod listeners participate? Let us know. info@thesaucepod.com. Hit us on Twitter @thesaucepod. None of you do it. You don't do it. Get on there and do it.
Nobody even goes on our website anymore. We don't get any comments.
Should we be live tweeting this right now? I don't think I could do both.
Tweeting while we podcast that.
We should have live tweeted your birthday party.
Yeah, live webcast that.
We should have live tweeted it.
Yeah.
What would you want the hashtag to be, Jim, if we did live tweet it?
I'm a man. I'm 40.
I'm a man. I'm 40. A man. Hashtag. I'm a man. I'm 40.
I don't know. Alleged rape.
Well, me and Rudy Pete Ringtone were trading some texts, and hashtag birthday rape was a good one. Or just a running rape list.
Again, funny because everyone knows I'm not a rapist.
just to reiterate, I'm not a rapist.
If I had even raped one person in my past, that would have been a horrible, horrible joke.
Yeah. And have you
ever been raped?
You've signed a contract wherein you cannot ever rape anyone.
Sure, yeah.
If you did, you would be exposed for the rapist that you are.
Yeah.
And you'd never
be
able to
be the mayor. We'd all know. We'd look back and say, God, that was the worst party ever. Right now, everybody thinks it was great.
We had a chance to stop them. The warning signs were clear.
But we didn't.
The warning signs were clear.
Warning signs.
This just in, the Crown Royal rapist has struck again.
It's funny. Every victim is found with a purple bag over their head.
Oh, this is getting a little...
That was the only thing that you raped that evening was the Crown Royal. That was the only thing that got raped.
Yeah, like I say, I don't drink often, and the reason why is because of what happened Saturday night, but every now and then you got to.
I can't speak to what happened after I left your company, but...
As far as I could tell, everybody that hung around with me had a good time, as far as I can tell.
They won't tell you if they did.
I had a great time.
I had a good time.
Good.
Even though you punched me a few times.
It was good. We all hung out.
Can I also compliment the high-quality Italian cookies?
Oh, yeah, thanks to the many chefs who contributed cooks.
Those are excellent.
Our cookies, for that party. Mm-hmm.
I like the balloons.
So
thank you.
Now that I'm 40, it's time to quit smoking.
Yeah, right.
Not today, but...
No, I got a plan. Starting tomorrow.
Oh, boy.
Always tomorrow.
Well, I ain't going to ruin my birthday. Starting tomorrow, I'm only going to smoke 10 cigarettes a day.
It doesn't work.
Dandy, I know what you may have tried.
It doesn't work.
But I've tried many things, too. And the first thing I need to do is get my smoking to a reasonable, manageable level. Now, I know that tomorrow I could not have any. Too much going on in my life. I've done the cold turkey thing before. It's just awful.
We just did it.
You guys just all did the cold turkey
thing. That's right. So I'm going to do something that I know I can. I'm going to set a short-term goal, something I know I can attain.
Now, why do you want to quit smoking? Besides the fact that you're going to live longer.
Number one. I have
really
a daughter.
Make you live longer, though?
I don't know. I question that a lot. I let me put it this way. I don't know if it would make me live longer, but it will make me live healthier. I mean, I'll feel better as I age.
Next week, no smoking up here.
And hopefully,
I quit.
Well, I would have, if it was a Monday, and I'm not going to smoke 10 cigarettes forever, but once I have maintained that level, I might go down to 8. You know what I mean? Or I might go down to 4. I don't know. Right now, I'm not even worried about that. I'm going to go down to 10. Normally, I'm about 25 to 75 a day.
75?
No, about 25 a day to 45. 25.
I did 5 a day for a week, and I was a real fucking dickhead.
You mean four or five smokes in a week?
5 cigarettes a day.
So nobody noticed a change at all.
I'm like a 10 a dayer now, but like when I'm here, I probably smoke 4 or 5.
Well, so he smokes just as many as the 3 of us put together in a show.
That's not true.
It is.
Too. Check the ashtrays.
I'm here to up the average today, though.
Well, I've had 3, I think, this show.
2. You've had at least 4 or 5.
I'll tell you exactly how many I had. 3.
But if I smoke that, I don't know why I smoke so much when I'm here.
Because you're sitting around the table doing nothing but talking and having a few beers or turkey sandwiches. You know, I mean, that would be one of the hardest things is when, you know, you're just kind of hanging out.
It's a culture. Turkey sandwich culture, man.
Situation like this. But, yeah, now I get it to 10 because I know I can, so starting tomorrow. And the way I'm going to do it, it's pretty easy. about every 4 or 5 times when I think to myself, I'm going to have a cigarette. Like, I usually wake up in the morning, take the dog out, have a cigarette. Get in the car, go to Dunkin' Donuts. As soon as I get my coffee, have another cigarette. So tomorrow, I'm not going to have a cigarette till all that's over with. No, I'm going to skip them both because I know I can.
Of course you can.
Yeah.
But that first one is so great.
Well, I'm going to put it off for a while. But the danger with going with I'm going to cut back and only smoke 10 is that it makes each cigarette a reward or more of a prize. It does. So that's why it's counterintuitive to quitting, because it actually makes you crave it a little more. It seems like more of a special treat. But I'm aware of that, and I'm willing to face it head on. But
just go one every 2 hours.
One every 2 hours. Well, that would be probably less than 10 a day. So that's why I'm saying 10 is very attainable. It's ridiculous that anyone would have to smoke more than that. You know, and when golf season comes around, I don't, you know, I it might mean, okay, I'm going to smoke one in the front nine, one in the back nine, instead of one on the first fairway and one on the first green and one on the second tee. And
I'm getting anxious just thinking about this. It's like making me anxious. Yeah, and I don't smoke regularly.
Hey, look, it ain't pretty. It ain't pretty.
You should start chewing.
No. That's I don't want to do that. I don't like that.
I want to see you get all loopy off.
A woman should not choose a man who chews tobacco.
What about a woman that chews tobacco?
Gross.
Very
hot.
Yeah?
No.
No.
But it always seems that the hot girls are the ones who chew tobacco. Like the only I've seen three girls chew tobacco, and all three of them were hot.
A woman should not choose a man who chews tobacco.
Oh, I see. She should.
It stains his teeth.
Chew the man.
It soils his clothes. And it makes a chimney of his nose.
Where'd you learn this little ditty?
A thing like
You're
that.
Welcome.
Where did you hear that?
A thing like that.
Deadwood.
Oh, yeah. Good one.
Martha Bullock says that as she's teaching the camp's children.
Mm-hmm. Did you watch Kenny Powers last night?
I got it on tape.
Oh,
can't was
wait
it good?
Watch it.
Fuck yeah, it was good.
He's in Myrtle Beach. What a better place
Kenny
to bring him
Powers.
Than Myrtle Beach.
I'm going on vacation there with the fam.
When?
End of June. Yeah.
And you're probably not even going to play any golf.
No, I'm going to be Kenny Powers the entire week. You can bring coolers of beer to the strip clubs in Myrtle Beach.
When did you say you're going?
End of June.
It's going to be a hot time down there that time of year.
We got to get that Dandy song queued up when he says shit like that. Boom.
What else we got? Anyone? Angry anyone? Brad said you smoke more cigarettes on the course than anyone he's ever seen.
You shut the fuck up, Brad.
Without drinking.
He's back. That's Saturday night. Tony.
Yeah, no, I need to. I don't want to be known as the guy who smokes more cigarettes on the course than he's ever seen that's not drinking. I don't want to be known as that guy. So I'm making a change. I should have made it a long time ago. I look back when I turned 30, I quit cold turkey 8 days and I got sick as hell. And I wish I maintained it because that was a hard. I think if I did, that first 8 days was probably the hardest. If I could have made it to like 15 or 20, I might have been home free.
I've gotten 2 years in and then 3. I'm all right back.
And I don't know why you go back after all that time.
It's a lot easier than you think.
I only smoke when I travel. That's how I separate it. I come home, I let myself smoke all I want, but I don't smoke in my everyday life.
I only smoke when I breathe.
Well, I'm taking, like I said, a realistic approach to it. And I'm also looking at it is the fact that I don't think anybody really thinks I can do it.
I believe in you.
I don't want you to.
I don't believe you can do it.
Are you going to save the money from the cigarettes you buy and buy yourself? Like,
well, that's the other thing. That's the other thing that will be a nice bonus. But as I said, I don't think even those closest to me really think I can do it because, it's a big-time crutch.
It's going to be really hard for you, but I think you can do it. I don't think you can do it. You should visibly put the money, like, where you can see
it. Well, the way I am with money, though, it just doesn't – I won't even probably at the end of the day notice the extra money because I will have allocated it or spent it or done something. I just how I am. I'm not good at saying, okay, I'm going to take $5 every day and put it over here in this pile. And then when I get, $200, I'm going to go on vacation or something.
It's my boss.
You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, I know.
That's my boss is talking.
Yeah.
I'm not good at that type of thing. But you know what should actually naturally happen is if I were to quit smoking, I should have a lot more money left over at the end of the pay period. You know what I mean?
That's the logical conclusion, sure.
But I won't say to myself, okay, I would have normally spent this much on cigarettes, so I'm going to put this $20 in an envelope and then, you know.
Right.
But I understand your point, and I know that, and I do know the total dollar amount that cigarettes that I spent on them.
I don't even know how much a pack of cigarettes costs.
What are you talking about?
I just pay.
Well, you know what they cost.
No.
Take a guess. No idea?
It's different every time I go.
Yeah, but you got to bring about
bucks. No, about 10 bucks, right?
Yeah.
Nine, but seven. I couldn't tell you the That's exact ridiculous. Amount of a pack of cigarettes.
Well, they're different in different places.
That's ridiculous.
Why?
It's so much money.
Oh.
It is. It's stupid.
When I smoked regularly and bought packs of cigarettes, it was like $2.
When I started smoking, they were $1.87 a pack. $2.
When I started smoking, you could buy a pack of cigarettes and a small 12-ounce Mountain Dew for $3 at the smoke shop.
When I started smoking, I smoked Bristols, 87 cents a pack.
Nice.
You know?
When you started smoking, there was only one kind of cigarettes, Winston's.
No.
Pall Malls.
You know, filter. Lucky Strikes.
Yeah, $10 a pack. Holy smokes.
Holy smokes.
Most of it is tax. But
anyway. Well, yeah, because you go through, I mean, I don't think they're that expensive in Texas. I don't know, maybe like they're seven. But
yeah, they're last.
I drove through like whatever,
Pennsylvania,
South Carolina, North Carolina. They were super. They were like,
oh yeah, well, I have a friend from North Carolina. You've done that too. They come up and they bring me a couple cartons.
You can fucking walk through grocery stores in North Carolina with a cigarette in your mouth. They don't give a fuck.
If you're coming from the South and you don't bring me cigarettes and fireworks, fuck you. You're not my friend. That's it.
Fuck you. Go home.
So new segment coming up on the Sauce Pod will be how's Tony doing, quitting smoking. So next week at this time, I should have had 70 cigarettes.
And a shitload of money left over to buy fireworks with. It's going to be awesome.
That first Syracuse game when there's 1 minute left and it's a fucking tie game, you're...
I'm not a stress smoker. Although I suppose I kind of am, but not that way. Matter of fact, I think sitting through a Syracuse game, I wouldn't even really think about. I could sit, you know, and not smoke during the Syracuse game.
I think the best part about a sporting event is lighting that first cigarette, tip off or kick off.
Well, like if I go to the
That's
game
the best
in the
part.
Dome,
yes.
If I go to the game in the dome, I don't smoke when I watch.
I
the
find
game.
Smoking to be the best part about the sporting event.
My feet up on the coffee table.
When we did that Warrior Dash, the best part was...
We walked to the starting line with a cigarette in our mouth.
Yeah. Counterintuitive. So, Miracle Whip or
pack
Hellman's.
Up, pack up the mayonnaise.
Which is better?
Neither.
Here's
your bread.
Mayonnaise is way better
it
than
depends
Miracle
on
Whip.
The application, but I usually go with Miracle Whip.
Really?
Yep.
Salad
I use them both
dressing.
Equally, I think, for different things.
Miracle Whip's gross.
Does anyone ever put that on their salad?
No, macaroni salad.
If I'm making tuna, I just use mayonnaise.
Yeah, no, I agree with you there.
I put Miracle Whip in that.
No, probably not. I would use the mayonnaise too. I have both in my fridge.
Pickles.
I have both in my fridge. I like Hellman's though. If I'm going to have a mayonnaise, I like a mayonnaise from a brand I can trust. You know.
Well, you know what they say.
Now, Christine,
Miracle Whip's got a lot more sugar in it.
Does
yeah.
So,
yeah,
absolutely.
That's why
it tastes 100% a little better.
That. That's the tangy zip.
It's no coincidence.
Somewhere.
We're having a moment of silence for mayonnaise.
How does the other nutrition info stack up?
I don't know. It's too many numbers.
Yeah, it's tough for him.
It is.
Numbers, not a strong suit.
Reading them?
Just reading.
Reading.
Just reading.
Reading.
Mostly just reading.
We're working on that.
I'm getting better.
So your scavenger hunt.
Let's do this.
Tell me more.
Yeah, what's your idea?
You even think this through yet?
No, I just want to do it.
We should wait till the summertime so we can get a little creative with it. I ran once one of the greatest scavenger hunts in the history of Seneca County.
That's true.
The last one we did, my favorite one, was to find a drink chip that wasn't circular. You know, just like a piece of like
that
a
chip. That was one part of it, or that was a whole hunt?
No, that was one of them. That was my, that was.
So I where did you find it?
The Inland Reef in Geneva. It was a golf tee.
Oh, really? The reef in Geneva, huh? Yes. How many bars did you go to before you found it? Like, you obviously knew
all
some
the way
of them.
To there. From everything from Seneca Falls until we hit there.
And then the scavenger hunt was over for you guys.
Yeah, where were you going to cut it off? Like,
we had to go up there anyways to go to, like, the Moose Lodge or something. So we just
what was it? To get your picture taken in front of a Moose Lodge member?
No, it was to get somebody's membership card.
Oh, really? Anybody's?
Anybody's.
So how did you accomplish that?
We went to the Moose Lodge and asked for membership cards, and they told us to fuck off.
I imagine they would. Why would they want to give you the membership? So you failed. That was it for you guys.
Failed that one.
Oh, it was like a list. You get as many as you could.
Yeah, I think there were like 40.
See, the scavenger hunt I ran, you would accomplish a clue, and that would lead to the next clue. And then you'd accomplish that.
That's not a scavenger hunt, though, is it? Isn't that called something
it's
different?
In a way, it is.
Balderdash.
You being a dick, or...
I'm beginning today.
I think they're both scavenger hunts. It's just a different format. Different format, yeah. I prefer the list because some things you just can't do.
Yeah, that way it's not all or nothing.
Two live chickens.
Like getting old, filthy McNasty's leather jacket.
Yeah, that's hard.
Yeah.
Two live chickens.
I know where I'd start looking.
In your closet?
Former patrons. I do remember. I lived in a world where you could go just filthy McNasty's existed. I lived in that world and I was of age and I went and my band played there.
And they all
I went there when I was of age.
I'm a man, I'm 40.
But that's really just a number. Hey, how about a little something we haven't done in a while?
Man drink like that and he don't eat. He is going to die.
We save hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast.
Bet, babe, slide a piece of the porter. Excited, run the job.
Look here.
Stu, what are you drinking tonight?
I'm out of drinks, but I had a Diet Pepsi and a water.
Nice. Dandy, how about you?
Vitamin water.
What flavor?
Flavor, man.
Triple X.
Of course.
It's the only one.
Badass. Such a badass.
Save them for last because they're so good.
Saucy Joe.
Drinking a Saranac Irish Red Ale.
And, ooh, that's something different.
Yeah, it's what this, you know, it's one of the, they rotate them in and out of that.
Seasonal.
Mm-hmm. Down there, yeah.
And our special guest tonight, Christina, what are you drinking?
Speaking of trendy waters.
Yeah, it is. It's the trendiest of trendy waters. Well, I finished my Dunkin' Donuts, and now I'm drinking smart water. I feel smarter already.
Did you have one cream and
vapor
one sugar?
Distilled. Vapor distilled.
Did I have what?
One cream and one sugar. Now the dandy one would have filled that bottle up and used it for a week.
They've Months. Added electrolytes for flavor.
No, now I turn them in. Now you get 5 cents.
What about Yahooey?
I'm rocking out. I had a little Coke with my turkey, and I'm also rocking out a Dunkin' Donuts medium coffee, one cream, one sugar.
If so, I run the job.
Look at here.
Man drink like that, and he don't eat. Die.
You taking that walker home with you?
Yeah, I gotta bring it back to my grandmother.
That depends too.
Those are yours, bud.
Wow.
Are you serious?
So what's she doing? She's sitting somewhere.
Grandma, stay here. Don't move. I'll
be
back in 2 hours.
I pushed her down on the
couch
and I took her walker.
Yeah.
Terrible.
That's funny.
I was just thinking that to myself, too, that I had to bring that home. I had to, so I could remind myself.
You, what if I was like, that's mine, bitch. You gave me a gift.
I'd take it from you.
I'd push it down and take it.
What kind of a present was that? I knew Dandy was getting, he said, go up the stair, you know, go up the elevator because he had to get something out of his car. I'm thinking, ooh, what could this be? Maybe a little present for Tony? Who knows?
Oh, you got a present on
He gave
right.
me his grandmother's walker, and then he's taking it home with him, which I'm actually glad because I don't even want it.
Dude, I got you a package of 14 disposable underwear.
16, actually. 16? They may come in handy. I don't know when, but.
Someday.
I was trying to picture you going to a medical supply store to get that, and I'm like.
Fall Street Pharmacy. Right.
It could come in handy. Two words.
Role playing.
Ooh.
That's all I got to say.
She was like kind of looking at me like, what the fuck?
Really?
Don't judge me.
Yeah. You're working at a fucking pharmacy, bitch.
Well, you got size 38 to 52. Jesus, what do you think? What? I am size 38, but still, that's at the low end of that.
You're concerned they might not fit.
Well, they'll Andy thinks I'm fat.
These are too loose.
They were. I didn't look at the size. I just saw large.
Oh, so you think I'm large?
Yeah. I could have got you extra large, motherfucker.
That's true. Yeah, they may just one day save my life, Dandy. So I'm not gonna.
You want to have some room in a disposable diaper?
Yeah, you want.
Yeah, that's
room.
True.
You know what I mean?
Better too big.
We covered that story about the woman, the astronaut who drove across the country. Yeah.
She was maybe next episode I'll sit here with one on and I'll piss myself for you.
That is the perfect thing awesome. For you to do. That's the kind of thing
we've
been
talking about needing to generate some buzz.
Dandy,
you low down dandy.
Well, we play that song.
I'll just sit here with a smile on my face.
Tune in next week. Dandy soils his absorbent disposable underwear.
Jessica says she can see up your nose.
Oh, tell her I said thanks.
Who said that?
You can tell her.
Oh, yeah. Jessica, thanks.
Can you see up my nose?
And she actually called it a nose bone.
Actually, that's probably rude.
Yeah, that's definitely rude. That's Rudolph P. Ringtone.
Former guest on the South.
Oh, sorry. It's Jessica. Sessica.
Sessica?
Gina Carope.
That is definitely Rudy.
Yeah.
I hear Ringtone was angry that you just offered to rape and didn't do it to him.
Well,
pull down your pants, Rudy.
As I said before,
I'm going to rape you.
I'm not one who rapes, just one who threatens.
Hashtag birthday rape.
After several shots.
Several.
I was, you know.
Crown rapist.
I can drink a lot.
As evidence, I
can testify to that.
See, I used to. This is similar. I used to drink quite a bit in my early 20s, and it got to the point where, you know, I think to myself, as I'm 7 o'clock heading down to the bar, is my mouth starts watering, thinking about a Tanqueray and tonic, and how much I just want to start drinking. And that's when I said, you know what?
Time to shut off that. Yeah,
time to. And it there was no joy in it after a while too. So I decided, and I'm not the I realized too, I'm not the kind of guy that just has one or two drinks usually. Usually, once I get that first one or two down, it's over. So
did you rap again?
Did I rap again?
No.
What do you mean?
No.
Oh, at the party? Yeah.
He may have busted the occasional rhyme, but he didn't showboat it in front of everyone.
No, I wasn't out to flaunt.
No, certainly not.
Not flossing.
You didn't jump through your leg either.
Because I can't do that anymore, and I've given it up. It will never happen again. I've tried and failed too many times before.
In his younger days, he was the kind of guy that jumped through his leg, but not anymore. There's no joy in it.
No, but there would be joy. There's no joy in the fact that I can't do it.
He would have been using that walker if he
tried it. The only joy in it is the other people who watch you do it, and when you bust your ankle, it's joy for them.
I've watched you fail at it.
And we're joyful. And we're joyful, as I was.
I haven't pulled that off in 8 to 10 years, honestly.
No, it hasn't been that long.
Oh, I think it has.
No, five.
So
definitely.
So you've seen it successfully done? You've seen
Absolutely.
Me do it?
Yeah,
I've seen it done successfully, and I've seen you also fail.
The time before Snowcone's wedding, you pulled it off, I remember. And it was probably 5 years ago. Snowcone's wedding, epic failure.
Yeah, I hurt myself that night.
European-style sex party.
another fine evening.
I showed up to that with a breast pump.
Oh, yeah, you did.
Yes. That's how they do it in Europe. It's not for breasts. I'm just.
And on that note.
Yeah, I think it's probably time we got up and out of here. I'm going to enjoy my last night of smoking uninhibitedly.
Hey, all Cones, right. where can the fine folks find you online?
Oh, you can find To Dine For at todineforhouston.com. And I also write a little bit for the Houston Press, so you can find me there. And at Snowcones on Twitter.
Don't forget Twitter. I follow Snowcones on Twitter.
It's good. She's a good follow.
Yeah, that's a good one.
All the good, cool kids stuff.
Do you follow this new young upstart, the Evil Most Wizardo?
That is my most recent favorite.
He's a good one.
He's a good one.
Evil character.
Make sure you follow him at Evil Most Wizardo.
As long as we're doing plugs.
And if you were looking for Rudy P. Ringtone, you can find him at bullsrungrill.com.
That's right.
Now, before we get out of here, it was my birthday today, so anybody who with a Facebook account knows that it's craziness on your birthday on Facebook. Mm-hmm. Holy Jesus. Happy every time birthday. You log on, the little red number keeps popping up.
Hope you have a good one.
You're not the guy that thanks everybody. Like,
well, you know,
me personally?
No. You know, well, listen, you know what I did?
Like it. That's the fastest way to do it.
You know what I did previous years? I think I just would log on at the end of the flurry and say, thanks, everybody, you know. So great to have so many friends and people who I don't really know that well, but you took the time to click on a link and type me a note. This year I liked everyone as they came across. I just like. And occasionally when someone said something particular, I might respond to it, but that was very occasionally. But I checked probably 4 times today. I may have missed some. But the thing about it is kind of weird because there are a lot of people on there that you either don't see anymore but you knew like in college, or people on there that you went to high school with or even live in town but you don't really associate too much but you know of them. But at least at the moment when they are sending the birthday greeting, they are thinking of me.
Yep.
You know? Mm-hmm. And when I read it, I think of them. So for whatever that's worth, screw it.
They might be thinking, they might be thinking of their...
I was
how
about
they
to make
remember
a beautiful point.
Go ahead.
But forget it. You were about to make a beautiful point, and then you just chucked it.
No, I'm just saying that there's just that little bit of acknowledgement, you know, because I don't think anybody would take the time to do that if they legitimately didn't like me.
No.
So
I don't even,
say
happy birthday
say happy
to,
birthday.
Like, my good friends on Facebook, though. Like, I don't understand why people do that.
You know, honestly, I only do it.
If I'm going to say happy birthday to somebody, I'm going to text you or I'm going to call you.
Well,
I'm not going to put it on Facebook.
I usually don't take part in the happy birthday. That's why I feel guilty today, is I'm being showered with birthday accolades.
You're 40.
Yeah, 40. But if you do
it. Yeah, if I catch it, sometimes I'll do it. Right. Not all the time.
I don't like to do it because then you come up to those situations where, like, you do it for someone, you don't do it for the other one. But I do it for some people. You know, I actually... One time I do it is today. There's two special ladies out there that share a birthday with me that I went to high school with. So every birthday, usually, you know, I do give them a shout out on Facebook.
Special
you know.
Ladies.
Because we share the same birthday ever since we were kids, you know. So
you will forever.
Ever since
you will. It's going to happen that way.
Yep. Yeah. So every time it's my birthday, it's their birthday.
Were you next to them in incubators?
No, it doesn't go for that far back.
I share a birthday with the host of The Fishing Hole with Axe Nasty.
Oh, yeah?
Axe Nasty himself. Me and him have the same birthday.
Are you the same age?
No.
Okay.
And his head
is a lot
bigger.
I got a picture.
What are we, 3 days
when I was
apart?
A baby.
We're about 3 days apart. Three I days. Share my birthday with several people.
I have some. I share with a few people.
Yes. Oh, don't. Listen. Let me. I don't share my birthday with anybody. It's my birthday. I'm just saying, me and AJ have the same day.
Christina's birthday is the day before, day after Christmas, day before Christmas.
3 days
23rd,
before.
The 22nd. 22nd of December.
What a rip.
That is rough. That's rough.
That was a
rip. What
off.
A rip.
That is
Stu,
rough.
Same thing.
18th.
He's just a few days before.
Well, that even is a little better than the 23rd, because by the 23rd, everybody's in Christmas mode, full bore, and they're like, oh. Christina's birthday. we gotta stop this Christmas business for a second and have a good old fashioned birthday cake and candles.
That's right.
So unfortunately, the timing of that probably. But then again, I bet you there were some efforts made to do something extra special for your birthday.
For sure.
Yeah. So
and my mom was always pretty. You know, like don't.
Your mom
give
was always pretty.
She didn't like the combination right. gift. You know, she wanted me beautiful my birthday point. Present to be wrapped in birthday paper, not like Christmas paper. Stuff
she
like
made
that.
A point.
You well, you know Martha. She loves. She knows how to make a point.
She knows how to wrap a present too.
No, she does know how to wrap a present.
There's no doubt about that.
You should see her fold the fitted sheet on a bed. It's like.
It's this move. I know that move.
It's such a. It's incredible.
I know that when you turn
amazing.
It inside out.
It looks
out,
like an envelope.
I was trying to do it yesterday and couldn't.
It's
figure
a cool
it
move.
Out.
Look it up online on howtodoit.com. I don't know if that's a website, but
howtodoit.com.
Yeah. howtodoitlikemartha.com, right. Not Stuart. How to do it like Martha. Utico.NotStuart.com.
I just rolled it up.
It's a good domain.
Check that
now,
out.
Now, the other thing about my birthday being February 20th, President's Day observed this year, but it was always fell during the President's Day break. So back when I lived in a world where you got, you know, go to school on those days or stuff, or maybe if I worked at a bank, I could still, you know, enjoy it. But I never had, like, school on my birthday.
Best
so it was
ever.
Like extra special boy I was.
To this day.
You're still an extra special boy. All right, let's wrap this up. Didn't we try that 5 minutes ago?
Happy President's Day, everybody.
Happy President's Day.
Thanks, Cone.
Should we all pick a favorite president before we go?
Calvin Coolidge. Go, Dandy.
The a what?
A favorite president.
Rutherford B. Bill Hayes.
Clinton. Good one. I like that.
Christina.
Staying contemporary.
I'm a big JFK fan.
Saucy.
I said Rutherford B. Hayes.
Come on, Jimmy Carter.
Jimmy Carter.
No!
You guys took all my good Democrats.
My favorite president, I honestly probably isn't Calvin Coolidge. I just think of the president names. That's my
what
favorite.
I was saying.
Yeah.
That's not my the favorite only president.
I would go with Reagan. Reagan's my favorite.
Is Dukakis, and he didn't even.
He wasn't
he
a president.
Wasn't even pres- he ran, though.
He drove That's a tank. True. He did run.
But I remember that name because we used to laugh at it in elementary school. David Dukakis.
No. Michael Dukakis. The first part name wasn't the funny part, though.
Dukakis.
I was like 8 years old. Come on.
Cut me some slack.
All right, you guys. Christina, thanks for joining
thanks
the sauce.
For having
you got something
me,
quick, Joe, to intercede?
No. Thank you. I love you, Christina.
I love you, too.
We're at thesaucepod.com. And as for the other particulars, you know where to find us.
Get See your grandma's next. Walker back.
We hope you enjoyed listening to this episode of The Sauce Podcast. Subscribe to our feed at thesaucepod.com. Look for us on iTunes and the Zune Marketplace. Contact us at info@thesaucepod.com. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/thesaucepod. We'll see you next week. www.fingerlakes1.com